$2 off per bottle. Mention GCN. Buy SinoFresh.com. It works.
I say I shot the sheriff, but I swear it was in self-defense.
I saw Sheriff John Brown.
All of a sudden, I saw Sheriff John Brown.
He was coming with a gun to shoot me down. So what did I do? I defended myself. I guess that makes you a terrorist. Helga, listening in Austin, Texas, on 90.1 FM. Helga, you are on the air. Welcome to the airwaves.
Hi, Alex. I hope you know that you are always in my heart.
Yes, I recognize your voice. You'd moved to Germany. Are you coming back and visiting?
Every year I'm here right now visiting. And I have to say thanks to Bob, because otherwise I couldn't afford it.
Oh, really?
Oh, Bob gave you some good advice.
Bob gave me some very good advice, which I followed. I had a little, it was a little scary, but I did, and I'm really glad I did. So, Alex, I'm just so, I just wish we would have, every country would have a steam engine like you.
Well, I'm pretty obnoxious, but I get the job done.
I don't think you're obnoxious.
We were a sweetheart.
I don't think so at all.
Helga, what's on your mind?
Actually, just before I left, they even told that the German government has to send their household budget to the IMF to be approved. Tabley didn't talk about, and I don't know if anybody else has talked about, but that's the last thing I heard before I left 3 weeks ago. And, Germany is only half as much in debt as Greece. So, but the IMF is, has been there a long time. Everything is being privatized. All the German cities, all the communities are bankrupt.
Well, Germany never got out from underneath the Marshall Plan. It's been a corporate colony since then, and now all of us go under this corporate Borg. Bob, had you heard about what Helga's mentioning?
No, I haven't. And but I can imagine it. What surprises me is Helga says that the the local cities and towns and counties are having financial problems as well. And that to me is surprising.
Totally bankrupt. My city where I was born, even the graveyard is privatized. And on
right?
top of it, they lost billions on Lehman Brothers. I mean, they are, it's just absolutely, and I had been fighting there a whole year against privatization of the last things, which was the buses. And people just don't know about the IMF. I mean, they have been working behind the curtains for a long time.
Yeah, privatization is not privatization, to boil it down for new viewers and listeners. It is private corporations becoming government and charging you a lot more money for it and stealing the infrastructure that the people paid for.
Right. And they do no repair. And if it's totally broken, I guess they're going to give it back to the people again. Something like it. I don't know. Maybe not. Just everything falls apart.
What was that, Bob?
Maybe the people will take it back.
I mean, so far, every city in Germany is broke. Everything. There are also no jobs around. And, we have this government handout which makes everybody paralyzed.
And that's why you're broke. That's why Helga, it's so good hearing from you. I've seen Helga over the years out at events and down at the TV studio, and she's just a great lady. And I got your call a few weeks ago, Helga, and then the number was around here somewhere, and I meant to call you back to see what it was going on. But it's good to hear your voice and call in more often, Helga. You're awesome. We'll be back in 1 minute with Bob Chapman with more of your phone calls, and I'm going to get into what's happening in the Gulf as well. Stay with us.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Be sure to visit GCNlive.com today.
The Fall of America and the Western World is an all-new 10-hour documentary and survival guide rolled into one. In this film, you will see the reasons why our government is failing and what you can do to prepare. Featuring Dr. Paul Craig Roberts, Joseph Farah, David Icke, Naomi Wolf, G. Edward Griffin, Doug McIntyre, Mark Crispin Miller, Mickey Z, Doug Casey, David McElhaney, and myself, Alex Jones. Protect yourself and get the tools you need to protect your family from these difficult times. The Fall of America and the Western World at www.thefallofamerica.net or click on the banners at Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. Again, that website's www.thefallofamerica.net or call 800-655-1577. Prepare yourself and the ones you love today. fallofamerica.net.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
We are already into hour number four on this Friday edition. Bob Chapman's our guest. For about 10 minutes, we've got Mr. Veach, who was arrested and made national news headlines in Canada for no reason. Headlines, secret lawless police arrest for failing to show ID near summit or any other reason. We're going to also get into what's happening in the Gulf. And we have a lot of really amazing reports, even the Washington Post now talking about evacuating 20 million people. If a hurricane or a tropical storm blows that oil in, we're taking your calls right now for Bob Chapman. He joins us every Friday. Of course, his website's theinternationalforecaster.com. Amazing info there. And we, of course, have Infowars.com. Anti-Federalist, you're on the air. Thanks for holding.
Hey, guys, you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I want my questions for Bob. Bob, what? Why gold? And if the world were to come into Armageddon, okay, I know that gold's been traded for centuries and been used for economies, but how is it going to do me any good if the world really were to go into Armageddon, and how can I possibly afford a substantial amount to actually make a difference in my own life? And also, if you could, please explain HGR 192 and how the Constitution says no state shall accept anything other than gold and silver as tender in payment of debt, and how now we cannot pay for anything because we have no money.
Okay, Anti-Federalist, I want to make some comments, but first, Bob.
Well, I think that as far as the HD or whatever the name of the bill was is concerned, you know, that's been on the books for a long time, and government just ignores it. They just very simply do what they want to do. And as far as Armageddon's concerned, if Armageddon comes, nobody's going to have anything, the way I interpret it. And so if you're worried about that, it's more important you have food and water and a way to filter your water.
Well, we haven't talked about gold yet today, and gold is just one of the things. Firearms, food, water, friends, skills, having a plan. So an emergency happens, a meteorite, nuclear war, World War III, evacuations, that you're not dependent on government, because look at Katrina and every other disaster. They can't and won't help you, Bob.
That's right.
Let me briefly comment. What I really heard there, and we all give into this, is kind of this psychological attitude of the world's going to hell, so I might as well go drink a bunch of beer and eat cheese enchiladas and smoke cigarettes. And I've done that before in my life. The government's threatening to kill me, and this will never, you know what, I don't care. I'm going to go eat a bunch of enchiladas and drink eight Dos Equis. You can't have that attitude. You know, the end of the world could be next month. I don't think it is, but let's say it was. Do the right thing now. Live your life. Is gold a silver bullet? Is gold the pantheon to save the whole world? No, it's just better than fiat money. It's better than fiat stocks and bonds and derivatives and things that are questionable and that can be revoked or devalued with a stroke of a pen or in the twinkling of an eye or over time with gradual inflation and devaluation of currency. And so, you know, there's always this cop-out. You see it in the Christian church. Well, the end of the world's coming, so I'm not going to go out and warn my neighbors about the takeover and the microchips and the police state and the fluoride in the water. And I've been hearing that for 15, 16 years since I've been active. I know you've been hearing it for 50, Bob. When we come back, I want you to briefly speak to it. But this caller, you know, what he said pretty much encompasses it all. Of course, you could die in a car wreck today and have a safety deposit box full of gold and never use it. You could die in a car wreck and not use $10 million in stocks and bonds people may hypothetically have out there. I mean, what does that mean? Or the government in 1933 under War Powers Act, confiscated gold. Yeah, my grandmother remembers her father not turning his in Dallas. And my grandfather remembered his dad, who owned a car dealership, not turning it in. And people just buried it. That's the old, you know, the old mason jar thing. And they did well a year later after the gold confiscation when the government doubled the price because they, the bankers, had hoarded it. So, I mean, just because the government might take your house, don't have a house, the government might take your kids, never have kids, the government, you know, if you get your wife pregnant, the baby might have a medical problem, so let's not have a baby. Oh, I might.